When we speak of Lord Ganesh, for example, elephant head, human body, did we have that kind of advanced knowledge of surgery? Were we far more evolved than we are, or even to reach that stage even today?
Lord Ganesh's story again is metaphorical, because the core belief in that is the acquisition of knowledge through detachment. And in fact, I had written on this in one of my books, which is why Lord Ganesh is considered the god of the writers, not just because he wrote the Mahabharata, but because he was the most intelligent. But there is enough evidence of, very advanced surgery in ancient times. There are descriptions of surgical instruments in Shushruta and Charaka's texts. If I remember correctly, some 52 surgical instruments. They had, they had stitching techniques for wounds in those days, where they used a herb called dadichi, which would actually leave no scars and which was itself an antiseptic. Imagine the stitch itself was antiseptic. We were seriously advanced, and we lost most of it in the last 1,000 years, but much more rapidly in the last 200, 300 years. We have to revive it.
Perhaps. You're absolutely right. And is that effort actually happening? Are we moving in that direction? Are your writings or your effort a step to at least attempt to open minds in our country? A desire by the next generation to know more about our history and our culture. Do you see that change happen?
I think the demand is certainly there. I'm sure our youngsters, and I've sensed it whenever I've interacted, most of my readers are actually the youth. When I interact with them, they want to learn these things. The problem is, frankly, with our generation and with the so-called establishment, that we are not helping the youngsters learn all this. Our syllabus needs to change. Our history texts need to change. The way we teach science needs to change. The way we teach medicine, we need to teach of our own traditions first, and then teach the Western traditions as well. But in the modern way, we teach only Western traditions and nothing of our own traditions. And you see the problems that this causes across our, like Vastu Shastra, for example, is not actually about superstition. It is a deeply scientific way to build buildings in our own climate, right? Because what is an architecture technique for Western Europe doesn't work in India. Glass wall buildings work very well in Western Europe. It's a cold countries with a shortage of sun, right? But glass wall buildings in India is essentially a giant microwave oven where there's no shortage of sun. We need to use our own techniques, which is there in the Vastu Shastra, but we don't teach them, right? The fault is with the system that we don't teach these things.